What are the fundamental approaches used in mechanical design today, and how are they about to change pretty dramatically? Let's talk about that next. Let's talk about the fundamentals of mechanical design. Before we get started, if you want more guidance on technology-led initiatives, especially for engineering, follow us or subscribe to our channel to get more insights like this more frequently. So with that said, mechanical design, you know, there was a big change back when computer design software kind of came out. It was a big state change for the approach of mechanical design, because those capabilities were very powerful and they could allow engineers to do things they could never do before. We're now on the verge of the same type of state change in mechanical design. There's emerging technologies that are going to make a huge impact, open up a lot of new possibilities in terms of design, and that's what we're focusing on with this series. But first, let's talk about a little bit of context. It's important to understand kind of what are the primary levers that mechanical engineers can pull today in terms of really making a difference with their designs. So let's take a look at that. When it comes to developing a mechanical design, there's really three things that mechanical engineers can do to kind of affect performance and capability and requirements fulfillment. One is developing the shape. And I call this macro geometry. You'll understand here why in a second. But this basically determines the outer shape of the component, maybe of the assembly. And there's lots of capabilities that we've had here for a while. There's some new capabilities here as well. So parametric modeling has been around for a while. Direct modeling, allowing you to push and pull geometry directly as opposed to working through features and parametrics, which is what you have with parametric modeling. And then subdivision modeling. That's a new one that has become more widespread recently, where you can kind of progressively add controls. It's kind of like direct modeling, but with a little bit more organic control. So that's one of the, you know, kind of levers that mechanical engineers can pull. Another one is microgeometry. Now, you know, to date, there hasn't been a whole lot of control for mechanical engineers here. You know, basically this has been a lot of solid components or solid geometry. And you could get down to microgeometry if you really wanted to model very small details, but that could get very taxing on the computer-aided design software that you're using and the computer hardware that you're using. That can get taxing very quickly. So you can get into lots of performance issues. But today it's mainly, you know, just solid geometry or solid stuff that you work with. The last one is material properties. And to date, you know, you have material selection that is basically homogeneous, right? So you have the same material properties in any spatial direction. And you could select one. And of course, there's been lots of advancements with composites and things like that. But in general, there hasn't been a whole lot of control with material properties and microgeometry. It's really the big lever that mechanical engineers have been pulling today to control their designs for components has been this macro geometry, this macro level geometry, and changing and shifting the geometry and controlling what that outer shape really looks like. Okay, so let's stop there and talk about this for a second, because, you know, to date, the primary mechanism or lever, this is what I keep referring to it as, for mechanical engineers to kind of fulfill requirements, make sure they hit performance targets and fulfill costs and all those types of things, have been shape, geometric shape. And that's been, you know, limiting. It's interesting because not only is it just geometric shape, but that geometric shape has been very constrained by how you can manufacture it, right? So if you're using casted components and then machining, you know, out of a block or out of a casting component. To control costs, you really are even more constrained. Like three-axis machining are only applicable to certain scenarios, right? You can't necessarily get in really deep holes. If you want to avoid five-axis machining for costs, that further constrains you. So, you know, mechanical engineers have been, you know, this has been the reality for a really long time, right? But this is part of what, you know, this is part of the context that's changing for mechanical designers, actually in all three of these areas. All right, that covers macro geometry modeling. If you're interested in the other two things that are affecting the future of mechanical design, macro geometry modeling and material properties, make sure that you subscribe or follow us and catch the rest of the series. Take care and talk soon.